On Earth's surface, sunlight drives photosynthesis in plants, microbes, and algae. But in the deep sea beyond the reach of the sun, microbes harness energy from chemicals that come out of volcanoes and vents. All living things on Earth need minerals and elements that they get from the crust. It's no exaggeration to say that all life on Earth is inextricably tied to the rocks upon which we live and the geological processes occurring deep inside the planet. Some of the chemicals that come out of hydrothermal vents, for example, work their way into the upper ocean and provide trace iron and trace elements that are important to all life. That's like the ocean's multivitamin.
Human ocean exploration spans our entire history. Millennia saw milestones like the Polynesian wayfinding, Viking exploration, and the invention of the compass. The 19th century surged with ocean discovery, epitomized by the four-year Challenger expedition in 1872. Here, biologists, chemists, and geologists worked together to paint the first true interdisciplinary portrait of the deep sea and shaping modern oceanography in the process.
Oceanography was transformed throughout the 20th century. Its trajectory was hugely influenced by two world wars. From deep diving submersibles to sonars and diverse tools, innovations bloomed. Many expeditions specialized solely in physical oceanography, geology, chemistry, or biology. In recent years, though, the scientific community recognized the importance of interdisciplinary research and the way it can enrich our understanding of our planet.
All right, are you ready now?
Los respiraderos de Galápagos muestran de forma perfecta el vínculo entre la química, la geología y la biología. La energía surge de los respiraderos hidrotermales, liberando agua químicamente rica y calentada desde abajo. Los microbios prosperan de manera única en compuestos como el hidrógeno, el sulfato y el metano. Sostienen animales como cangrejos y mejillones, formando la conexión de manto microbiano a mejillón. Los lazos de la vida con los procesos profundos de la Tierra se iluminan aquí en estas aguas.
A tremendous amount of bacteria are contained in the water that exudes from the vents. And for this particular discovery, one would say once in a lifetime, something occurred like that.
It's amazing to think that the first scientists that saw hydrothermal vents didn't even know what they were looking at.
That's true. In fact, they didn't even have the tools to make the temperature measurements. In fact, the aluminum temperature probes they used actually dissolved in the hydrothermal fluids. So vent chemistry allows us to do two things.
RVs in the water. Yeah, so it's submerged and then make a turn.
The first thing is to give us a glimpse of what's happening beneath the seafloor. And the second thing is that allows us to study the microorganisms and animals that live on and above the seafloor.
We used lots of tools to sample these sites, including the IGTs, which are able to sample at high temperatures and pressures and can keep fluids and gases in their natural state all the way up back to the lab.
These hydrothermal vents show us so much about how minerals form.
Yeah, and actually we're learning that not only do these sulfides harbor microbes, but these microbes are altering the mineralogy in the sulfides themselves.
Gaining a better understanding of these microbe-mineral interactions helps us think about how microbes can live in these environments, and it also helps us think about what types of microbial metabolisms may be out there that we don't understand yet.
Some animals at hydrothermal vents can become really, really large because they live in symbiotic relationships with bacteria.
Yeah, and others graze on the microbial mats that are found here. And some of the species that we've been looking at can tolerate incredibly intense thermal and chemical conditions. It's amazing.
This work is important because we have the opportunity to try to understand whether the deepest parts of Earth, whether the heat expelled from the mantle actually imparts change to ecosystems that are inhabiting the seafloor. So in a very direct way, we're linking very deep Earth processes to life that's living at the very surface of Earth.
So imagine these disciplines as pieces of a jigsaw puzzle, each contributing to the whole picture. There's this interplay between geology, chemistry, and biology, and studying one without the other leaves us with an incomplete understanding. But with an interdisciplinary approach, we have all the pieces of the jigsaw puzzle and can finally see the whole picture. As we piece together the biological, geological, and chemical mysteries of the Galapagos vents, it's really clear that interdisciplinary science gives us a more complete understanding of how these processes are linked here and around the world. You okay with that one? You sure? What else you got?